Welcome to my channel, A Folly Fat Danny Nights, where I talk about my hobbies, interests and toys. But today, are we talking about toys? Oops, I see a video sliding off. I have a cash receipt. So I went to the Bruna store. That's a store in the Netherlands, but this case, a store in Rotterdam, near my house, Central Station, Rotterdam. And it's actually a bookstore. So we can get candies, magazines, books, notebooks, stationery, whatever. So here I have three items here. And you can see it clearly. There you go. I'm going to take it out, the scene. So, I walked immediately to the place because I couldn't find it in the initial place. But the initial place is more for normal magazines and normal things. So I had to go around the corner because around the corner is more for kids. So there I found this. It's a Lego City book. I've seen it in the 80s, in the 90s. I think I've never purchased one. This is the first time that I purchased one. I bought a similar book, but I bought it more the Pokemon version. Because my kids were into Pokemon, so they get a cartoon book. And always a present inside. So I'm going to open this one. Because the plastic bag and my desk light creating a glare, so you cannot see the image of the magazine. Let's take the bag out in my garbage bag. So let me put this aside. I'm gonna take off the stand. Let's go. So here is. Oh, yeah, I'm charging also my cell phone, so this magazine gives you also a free set because you get a minifigure, an agent, and his motorbicycle. And I thought to myself, I've seen some motorbicycle on Lego sets and poly bags, but this one. I hear my son walking. I think he's going to work. And I've seen for the first time a futuristic motorcycle. I'm like, woo, I'm in. So I've never seen a motorcycle like this. It's not that I'm a motorcycle buff, but when I was working for my friend, that's no longer my friend anymore. I think I'm more friends with her husband. But that not in that way, okay? I was an employee in their stores. So they both can drive. I cannot. So I'm always sitting in their car and driving on the highways. And then he said, my ex-friend, husband said to me, oh, one day I want to learn how to drive a motorcycle, because he has already all the driving license that you can get. So he already have that. The last one is the motorcycle one. So, and always when you drive on the highway, because I live in Rotterdam, but they have a family in The Hague. So sometimes he goes to The Hague and then he asks me, do you have something to do? I say, no. When you want to come? So I said, okay. But I don't know your family. He says, no, well, that's the best opportunity to see them now. So we drive on the highway and I always see the motorcycles. So I see a lot of motorcycles around. But this one I've never seen. That's weird. But it doesn't matter. It's in this bag. It's a beautiful aluminium bag. Normally it's a see-through bag Well, I've, like I said, I've never purchased these kind of things. I've always seen it in the past, because I always bought the lady kind of magazines, of fashion magazines. Oh, I'm sorry, it's not lady magazine, it's women's magazines. And, yeah, I've never seen them. Oh, I see, I can feel it. The bicycle is already made. You don't have to assemble it anymore. And the agent, the cop, is also ready made. So it's all, it's two pieces. So all you have to do is let the agent or the cop sit on the motorcycle. That's all you have to do. Oh, everything is all, like I said, ready. Even though it says here 13. Wait. No, I've got it wrong. No, you have to assemble it. It has, it says it 13 pieces, but you have to still assemble it yourself. Okay, that's okay. Not a problem. So, like I said, I've never bought these magazines, but I've heard that Brixar is very, well, not jealous, but he wants these things also. You know, these Lego magazines. I've seen the normal ones, the normal Lego magazines. This is the Lego City. So you have the normal ones, you have the Lego Cities. I saw the Ninjago ones also. So there are three kinds of these kind of magazines. So, Brixar, if you want to buy it. I think it's easy to subscribe to those. I don't think it's difficult or impossible. If I can buy it just in the store, I think you can buy it online. So you get all these things. This cartoon. Oh, there's the instructions how to make the... That's nice. To make the bicycle, motor bicycle and a cup. There's a, what's this? A quiz. And Billy Bones. I've never heard of Billy Bones. What is that? Hey, Lego fan, are you crazy about cars? Then this is the book for you. Lego, build and sticker your own car. Oh, okay. Never heard about that. Another cartoon. Okay, look. Kijk. Kijk is Dutch for look. It's a poster. Nice. It says Team Cop. And the other is the motorcyclist. Stop in name of the law. Oh! Stop in the name of the law. Billy Bones again. I don't know. What is Billy Bones? I don't know what Billy Bones is. These are books. Yeah, reading books. Then what's this? Game. Game. There's a little quiz there. Another cartoon. And Ditches and Dutches. I don't know how to translate that. Bips and Bobs. Yeah, I think it's Bips and Bobs. Fan posts. Wanted. Wanted fan post. Okay. Oh, these are children that sent in their drawings. Okay. Oh, sorry for the flare. The glare. It's best to do it like this, on this side. Another cartoon. This is a game you can play with a friend. Another cartoon. Party Kaboom. Oh, I like this hairstyle. Wow. Is there a minifigure with that hairstyle? I don't like that criminal look that she's wearing. Mm. Whoa! What's that? Dynamite. Well, you know, Lego has a problem with dynamite. I'm sorry for laughing. Oh, this is for the next time. Oh, yeah. Oh. I didn't see this one. This is the latest, newest one. I didn't see this one. Oh, this is nice. This street sweeper. And I see all the pieces have like 30 something because this one has 31. No, sorry, 13 pieces. Oh, I thought it was 31. No, it's 13 pieces. But this one is 32 pieces. I see a lot of technical stuff. Okay. And then, oh, you can... I forget the name. Bookmarks. That's the word. Bookmarks. Okay. You can make bookmarks of these three strips of paper. Oh, this double-sided. Oh, right. Okay. So, that's the Lego City one that I purchased. So, I'm going to put it aside. Oopsie. Put this one also aside. I've bought, like I said, three things. I bought another Lego. This is Jurassic World. This is... Oh, wait. 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 I thought that I saw a normal Lego. What did I say? I said a Lego. Lego City. Or Ninjago. Okay. Oh, there was actually a fourth one. I did... This is the fourth one. Okay, you know what? I'm going to put you in the stand. I'm going to open this bag. As you can see, beautifully. I always wanted to buy a Lego set that was Dr. Wu's lab. This one, a set. A cute set with... the dinosaur eggs and the laboratorium of the Dr. Wu, but it was not the price or the set itself. The price was like $19.99 at the official Dutch Lego website store. That was not a problem. The problem was I am so into the hidden side things because I want to collect the hidden side things. And then I want to go to the Jurassic World. So it's still on my list, Jurassic World, but I still haven't collected all the hidden side things that I want. So that's why it's on the back burner. So in that set, you will get these things. But because I didn't buy the set, I'm already glad that I have this little bag. It says limited edition? What is the other one? Let me see. Oh God, where's the baggie? Of the cup. In the motorcycle. Oh, this is not a limited edition. Okay. This is a normal one. Is this a normal one? I've never seen this truck. Oh, it's raining outside. The children are screaming because it's raining outside. They get wet. So, I don't want to open it because it says limited edition. No. Oh. Can I carefully take it off? Oh, you can carefully open it. Look. It's like the AliExpress version bags. You open it and then you can close it again. So, okay. Let's open it. Okay, let's open it. Oh, I'm scared. I don't want to break the bag. Oh, no. I'm going to break the bag. No. Please not rip the bag. Wow, the glue of this double-sided tape is so sticky. Oh my goodness. Oh, that was a chore to open the bag. Carefully take them out. Because I can re-close it. So you have two by four plates. I can now assemble the Dr. Wu with, you know, wait, this is the front. Oh, sorry. This is front. This is a jacket. I'm going to put it in there. And then Dr. Wu. Oh, my goodness. Wait, I'm. You know what? I'm turning my ring light on. I only have my desk light on, so. There you have it. I wanted to show you that this is not the actual color of Lego head. The official Lego head is very yellow, and that's just the standard head color. And I don't know in what year they started to make several colors of the face. So you get the light pink and then nude color and colored color like brown, several kinds of browns. I think there's an olive skin also. And this is a different kind of color face. I like it. This is my first time I have a face with this kind of color. I always have the standard Lego, yellow Lego color for face. So I'm really happy I have this kind. Oh, look how beautiful this Doctor Who is. Nice. I like it. So you have the Doctor Who. I'm going to put aside. You have egg. Here, a mini egg and a mini dinosaur. Oh no, that's a syringe. Oh my goodness, look, a mini syringe. Okay, so now I have pushed these things aside. I'm gonna see from the picture. I need something. Oh, this is the base, and I put these two like this. You can put it left or right. I'm going to put it on the right side. So I'm going to put the syringe here. Like so. And I put the 2x4 on top. So the desk can be completed. Like this. And put the rear thing, a bottle. Look, it's a bottle with a ancient prehistoric mosquito. Oh, that's so funny. A mosquito. Oh, no, it was not a bottle. It was a stone. It was some kind of stone where the mosquito was trapped. This is some kind of wax that hardened all over the years. Millions of years. So I'm going to put it here. That's so funny. A mosquito trapped in a wax. And I'm going to put this like this. Wait, do I do it right? No. This? Yes. So, no. Why? Okay. That's the desktop. This is the keyboard for the computer. Like this. And then the screen of the desktop. Oh, this is the first time I have a computer. Yes, please. Thank you so much. Look at that. I'm going to put it aside. Oops, my egg. My egg. A dinosaur. Dr. Wu. Oh, look at this. I always wanted a Dr. Wu's lab. You know, the set. And okay, I don't have it. I have partial. I have a partial lab. Actually, I have his desk. But I love it. The mosquito now I forgot the word again. What is that? It's not wax. You know, tree juice. I forgot the word. Never mind. I'm happy. Oh, I don't want to put it back in a bag. You know what? I don't want to close it. No. You know what? I have this thing, you know? Maybe. If I can put this strip and then attach it like that. Maybe. Whoops. Can you hear it? It's raining now. And double it like this. And I'll rip it here. So I can do it like this. So, yes. In case I want to put it back in the bag. But I don't think so. Oh, I'm so happy. Now I want to buy the Doctor Who's lab. I still haven't purchased the one, the hidden side one. That's also a lab. I wanted to buy this one, but it's hard to find that set. Because in the time when it was in Rotterdam, the Rotterdam lockdown, you could go to drive-by at Intertoys, but I don't have a car and I can't go outside Rotterdam. So I couldn't purchase the hidden side, that spooky lab. I regret it so much. That I don't have a driver's license. I can't drive. I don't have a car, so that's a thing. I'm going to put it here. And I'm going to open this beautiful... I'm going to take you out of the stand so you can watch with me. So this is the, like I said, the Lego Jurassic World. And you can... Oh, spoiler alert. You're not allowed to see. Oh, these are so funny. I didn't buy these dinosaur sets. So... Because I still want my hidden side. First, the things that I want. So I want Spooky Labs. What's the other one? The Attack on the Shrimp Restaurant. I have that already. Welcome to the Hidden Side. I have that already. So two have that already. There are some things I have from the Hidden Side. But the one that I don't have is the Spooky Lab. That one I don't have. Okay, so let's see. Here we are, open the magazine. So, look at this. He has a lot of stones. Beautiful. He dropped it from his car. He drove maybe too fast, or he stopped immediately. And all of those stones fell off the truck. Cartoon. So I'm gonna read it later. I'm not gonna read it now. And then Ninjago. They are advertising for subscription of the Lego Ninjago magazine. I didn't buy that one because I'm not so invested in Ninjago. So, but they are advertising here. Another cartoon of the dinosaurs. And then a puzzle, another puzzle, another puzzle. Ooh, look at this beautiful poster. Ooh. Four posters. So this is another one, and this is another one. It has in the center a big illustration, and then in the surroundings, as you can see, are smaller pictures with the dinosaur. So you can see... This is a Triceratops. Oh, wait. If I want to turn, I can turn around. I can see. So this is a Triceratops. Do you know I have that stamp? I bought it at AliExpress. It's somewhere there behind. I have that one. The same one. I think AliExpress was not allowed to do that. Am I going backwards? No, I'm good. It's the other side of that dinosaur poster. Here's the Velociraptors. It says here Velociraptor poster. And then here is a poster. It says Kickaboo. No way. Look at this poster. Oopsie. Sorry. I've seen... crystals from I have seen some crystals. I see two modified bricks in the shape of gems. I've seen the crystals, but I have not seen this one. So I'm not sure if this one exists, because this one does exist, the smaller brick here, one by one brick with a mosquito on, but I have never seen the actual crystal. with the mosquito on. So that's, I'm not sure it's just for fun, for, you know, illustration wise. Oh, look here. This is the instructions how to make the Dr. Wu's lab, you know, these things. So I already did that. I used the picture of the bag. I forgot, I already have the instructions guide here. But it doesn't matter, I have already done it, so. Oh yeah, you know, you see, I intentionally put the holder on the right side. I could have put it on the right, left side. Because on the picture it says it needs to be on the left side, but I don't, I'm rebellious. I never do anything that needs to be done. In the past I always did what authority says me to do. But nowadays I know that authorities does everything wrong and I don't need to do what everything they say. So that's why I'm rebellious. And I hate my Dutch government. So there's another puzzle. There's an advertisement for buying a book. Another cartoon. Let's see. It goes on. I will read it later. Off screen. And then there's another. No. You see? Because I'm, like I said, I'm so invested in Hidden Side. I can't grab it. I just cut my nails again. You see? I cut my nails again. It's so hard to grab. So, as you can see here, you can create a mini lab. What is this? Action in the research vehicle. Claire wanted all the time a new cool research vehicle to test it as a Gallimimus. Is it the name of the car? Gallimimus slips through the fence. Oh no, Gallimimus is this animal, this dinosaur. Okay, as the Gallimimus slips to the gate of his stay, she starts the strong engine and she goes after him. She says, wow, this thing has such a power. And then here, a very important mosquito. That's the thing that's on the table here that I already have. Oh, my Lady of Justice falls. Stay there. So apparently, if you have the stuff, I don't have them. If you have the stuff, you can create a mini lab like this. Well, the only thing I have is the egg. One egg and one of these stones. The stone mosquito. But I have another egg from there. From the carrot house. And I think I have another egg from another set. So I can combine all the eggs and then make this thing. But too bad, I have nothing here. The only thing I have three eggs and one of the stones. That's the only thing that I have. I have everything that is here, I do not have. So I don't know. Oh, look at the walkie-talkie. That's a printed one. I have the cheap walkie-talkies that everyone have in their sets. But this one, I do not have. This is such an innovating walkie-talkie. That's nice. I have the one, the black one, you know, with no print at all. I don't have, like I say, I don't have them. This set. Now I want to buy this set. But I'm not going to buy this set. I want to have the Hidden Side first. Look at this beautiful. It says, see, Dino Crash. Dino Crash means, a crash. Crash means in Dutch. I don't know if it's the same word in America and in England. But a crash means, it's a place where parents drop their children, babies, infants, to a place where people look after their kids. And after they've done working, they can collect their kids from this place. So the children there can do, they play by themselves or play with the other children, and they have their a whole day kind of a program. There are some people that are looking after them, that they are well fed and well played. That means they can get along with all the other kids. Well fed, I mean real food. I don't mean, you know, crayon, that they're eating crayons and stuff like that, and glue. Oh, look, see, there's another bicycle here. I think I have not seen this one. I have seen a bicycle, and there was some kind of Chinese boy delivering food. I saw that poly bag. This one is also nice, this motorcycle. I'm gonna turn it. So what is the? Oh, there are some puzzles in there, and here it says the solutions, how you can solve that puzzle. All the solutions. Oh, no. This is for next time, September 16, the new magazine from Jurassic World. Oh, goodness. Do I have Owen with that kind of hair? I don't think so. He looks kind of rough, you know, with his face like that, you see? He has some, how do you call it? 5 o'clock beard, they call it 5 o'clock beard. Oh, I'm not sure if I want to buy this. Oh no. It's so intoxicating. Once you buy once, you want to buy the other ones too. Oh my goodness. Oh, this is the poster that was inside. Was inside the, in the center of the, where the staples are. There was 4 kinds of posters, and 2 of them were, one of them is here, the T-Rex, and the second one is a Triceratops. But there are also 2 other posters. You can't see in the back of the magazine, but they are here. So the 3rd one is with Velociraptors. And there was a 4th one, but you can't. They didn't show the 4th one here. You have to unfold, take the staples out. So I'm really happy with mine. I didn't know it was so much fun, these magazines. So, as you know, I have the Lego Jurassic World, and I have the Lego City one. With the cool bike. I saw the bike, I said, that bike is mine. Well, in the store, the bookstore, they have loads of these. So, I think like 6 of them each. So, oh look, there's another walkie-talkie there. Look, oh no, that's not a walkie-talkie. No, never mind. That's not a walkie-talkie, oh my goodness. You know what? I'm gonna take this out because I want to show you the 3rd thing that I bought. I'm gonna push this aside because these are loose things. So I don't want to lose them at all. I'm not good. So, I was in the store and I saw this. It says here free Bruna summer bag, but I don't understand. This bag is shaped like squared. But when I got this bag, it was not shaped squared. So I don't understand. It looks like a tote bag. I've unfolded it. You see? It looks like a tote bag. You see with the corners? Like this. Is it? Wait. If I take it out, will it be squared? Because this, to me, this bag is different. This is an actual squared bag. This is not a squared bag. This is a tote bag. You know, I mean a tote bag like a beach bag. Is it the same on the picture? Look looks like it, but it's not. No, this is more the squared one. I know my bags. This looks like the squared one. Because as I fold it like this, wait, I'm going to show you. As I fold it like this, oopsie. You see? The from A to B here, it's too short. And here, from A to B, oh wait, from A to B here, it's a little bit longer. Actually, this is not the same bag as here presented. I know my bags. I've seen those squared bags, and they are, and when you fold them out, they are so big. And this one is, as I fold it out, it's not that big. You can still put your 25 euros groceries in there, but this bag looks like it's 50 or 70 euros items on products you can put in there. This one, you cannot fit 70 euros products when you've done groceries. So I believe this is a totally new other bag than here. Did they really think that I couldn't see that this is a totally different bag? Yeah, this is a real a squared bag. This is something else. This is just a tote bag. A shopping tote bag. Okay, never mind. I can't complain. I've bought it. I took it home. Okay, so on the cash receipt, there was a third item. So I have here a third item. I'm going to put it here. I have to tell a little story. So I'm going to put it closer. It says here, Willy van der Steen. So Willy van der Steen is the original writer of this cartoon, Suske Wiske. When I was small, a little girl, the only cartoon that I wanted to read, this is every month they come out with a new issue in my youth. This Willy van der Steen writer, or how do you say, the one that invented or thought about these two characters, Suske and Wiske. Suske is the boy, Wiske is the girl. She always has this kind of hair. She ties it, and then normally she ties it up, so the bow is up. But there's a reason why she ties it in the back. So Willy van der Steen, I don't know exactly year, but Willy van der Steen died. So there was big panic because Willy van der Steen is not from the Netherlands. He's from Belgium. Belgium is a country under the Netherlands. So you have the Netherlands. So you have here the England, the Netherlands, Germany, and the Netherlands underneath has Belgium, and underneath there's France, and underneath there's Spain, and underneath is Portugal. I mean, on the world map wise. So when Willy van der Steen died, it was a shock to me. When I heard about it, I cried. Because I love his books so much. And because I was poor, I couldn't afford to buy these cartoon books. And at that time, they were, to me, it was expensive. To me, but it was in guildens, it was not even in euros. And the only way I could read those cartoon books is when you go to the library, and because you're young, library is free. And soon as you turn to 21, no, no, when you turn 18, you have to pay for your library card. I don't know how to say. So every year you have to pay for the service that you take from the library. That means you lend books. So like I said, there was big panic when Willy van der Steen died. So what they did was, can we find a person that can step in his shoes? They were searching, they couldn't find, and finally they found the one that stepped in his shoes. So they still make these Siskawiska books under his name, Willy van der Steen, and not by the new artist, the new illustrationist, or the new storyteller, because Willy van der Steen did it all. He made the designs, he made the cover, the storyline, the pictures inside. And yeah, he was very famous in my time. So the moment that there came new issues out under the new illustrator, I have those. So, like I said, in my past, I didn't have the money. I didn't get allowances at that time. We were poor. I always lent read in the library itself. I didn't take it. Oh, yeah, I remember. You couldn't get a card from the library because your parents have to sign for it. So we went to the library with the whole school, not the whole school, with our class, because you have to take turns. So our class went, another class went on another day, or at nine, on another time. So later in life, when I finally earned some money, I bought a couple of these Siskawiskas, the old ones. You can still find the old ones, because in the market, we have a market here, the biggest market here in Rotterdam. We have a smaller market in West, and we have also a market in East, and all the other smallest ones, but I don't go to the smallest one. I only go to the biggest one, and in the West, that one. In those markets, the West don't have it. You can only get to the biggest one. So in the biggest market, there is where you can buy, you purchase secondhand items and products. And there's, on the side, there is this little stand where they sell secondhand books. And one of the secondhand books, they sell the Siskawiskas, the secondhand ones. But at that time was 2 guilders and 50 cents. I think it's now the same. Now you have to pay like 3 euros. But the price has gone up. So now, how much did I pay this one? So in the time it was in guilders, it wasn't that much money. I think it was 5 guilders. 5 or 6 guilders. I don't know anymore. It was sometime that one, that price. But now I have to pay 7 euros and 25 cents. So now it's gone up. The reason, there was a lot of Siskawiska's issues. I don't know when this one came out, because I've seen this before. Because there were a lot of issues of Siskawiska's, but I saw this there. I saw Lego bricks. I said, what? Lego bricks? I thought to myself, is Siskawiska allowed to draw Lego bricks on the cover? I think they are allowed, because there is no sign that it says Lego. So never, not anywhere, it says Lego. You can only see because of the bricks. You know the bricks, how they are, the shape, and you immediately know that's Lego. Those are Lego bricks. You know it. So the way how Willy van der Steen has a way of thinking about the story, I didn't know at that time. When I read the cartoon books, I always thought that storyline is so... I heard of that before. So the thing is with Willy van der Steen is he designs the title. So he says here the... How do you explain it in English? This word means silence, hush, not talking. How do you say it in English? I don't know how to explain it in English. But this is a makeup word. But if you squint a little bit, if you squint a little bit, it sounds like Gollum. You know, Gollum? I've got the movie again. Oh my goodness. You know, I forget the film movie. It was three part or four part. With the Hobbit, the Ring. You know the movie, what I mean, you know? Well, like I said, Willy van der Steen likes to mix it up. He creates a title with three words, and then he makes a beautiful cover. But the storyline here in every cartoon books he creates, always he creates a storyline based on 5 to 7 sources. The 5 and 7 sources he can find on newspapers, and he mixes it up. So if you know a little bit, if you read all your newspapers and all the news, and then you watch and you read these cartoon books, then you recognize some of these things that he combined is in one cartoon book. So here you can see someone is very rich. He can afford a lot of toys. And you can see all these toys here on the cover. I own this thing. This thing here in back. I have one in red. And then you see the Lego here. You can see all the toys in the back. You see the castle and things. But apparently I have not read the cartoon. But I think it's about an eccentric old man hiding in his castle. He can afford all kinds of toys. And I think he doesn't allow anyone else to play with his toys. He is the only one playing with his toys. I think that is what the main thing is. But if you know the story in the world, in books and films, and things around the world, he combines everything. So you can see all the toys here. The eccentric man having his toys. We have an eccentric man here in the Netherlands. And he is actually a famous piano player. He's called Wiebe Suryabi. I don't think he knows that, Wiebe Suryabi. Wiebe Suryabi used to live in a castle. And his house was filled with toys because he was so enamored with Disney. He loves to go to Disney. He loves to buy Disney stuff, Disney statues, you know, the Mickey Mouse, Donald Ducks, and etc. He loves plushes. He has the big plushes. He has everything because he's a well-known piano player from the Netherlands. He plays all over the world. So, and then he combines it with Gollum. So there's a lot of things here. But I said that I didn't read the inside. I only read the first page. So, let's see. So I read the first page. So here, where they live. So apparently, Sidonia. This is Aunt Sidonia. She lives with, Suske and Wiske lives with Sidonia. Aunt Sidonia, and the uncle Lambiek lives together with his friend, I've got a name, Jeromeke, oh yes, Jeromeke, and apparently there's a flood. Well, the thing is here, the Netherlands, like a month ago, it rained so much, it was flooded, but every year it's flooded in the Netherlands, like this time of the year, I think, like, actually, to be honest, the Netherlands is flooded 2 times a year, to be honest, one in spring and one in autumn. So when I saw this picture about this little town is flooded, I thought to myself, oh yeah. I don't know how if Belgium has been flooded, but I know for sure the Netherlands has been flooded like yearly, 2 times. So I saw this, I recognized it. So I said to myself, oh yeah, this happened to us a lot of times. It's flooded here in Rotterdam. So I know. Because here, when you walk out of my house, you go straight to, you walk straight the street out. At the other end of the street, my late uncle has his store. Well, he doesn't own it anymore because he's dead. The one that owns the store is my aunt that is married to my late uncle. She owns the store. Sometimes when it rains a lot, then her basement is always flooded. So I know this thing personally hits us. So now they are here in the second picture. You see, Suske is keeping the television safe, the tin one, the tin television, not the bulky 50-60s television. He's keeping the television safe, while Aunt Sidonia is keeping her toaster safe, and Suske is having a bucket and taking all the water out of the window. So he is now, I think, yeah. So Suske is calling on his cell phone, like Aunt Sidonia asked him, like, call Uncle Lambiek if we can live at his house, because we are flooded. So he says, oh, what a ravage. How do you say? What a land. I don't know how to explain this word. What an elende. Well, it's a thing that you say when you're in grief and you're not happy, the thing that happened. And the thing that happened is very bleak. So, and it says, hopefully we can go to him, you know. And he says, Lambiek says to the telephone, yeah, sure, we'll do. Hello. So he says, here he says he agrees that they can move to Uncle Lambiek's house, because their house is flooded, you know. Aunt Sidonia's house is flooded. So he says here, stay at my house? Sure. Come. So he says, you can come and help us scoop the water out. Because they are flooded too. He's reading the paper in his fauteuil. We call it fauteuil, but it's a soft chair. He says, yes, of course. It's also here flooded. We live here like just not far from each other. So like I live at the end of the street. So of course we are flooded, he says here. And he says, oh, it depends. So Jeronimo says here, oh, it depends who is throwing the stone. Lambiek or Jeronimo. Yeah. So, Willy van der Steen does not like to swear in his cartoons. So here, he kind of swear, but it's not an actually swear word. So he says, yeah, then. And he said, swear, kind of swear word. And he says, there goes our boaster again. So he is always jealous. Lambiek is always jealous at Jeronimo because he thinks he's boasting. He thinks Jeronimo is boasting. The reason why we say that, because Jeronimo, he is the strongest man of the world. He can lift things up. So he says here, are you still mad? Are you still mad? Because you didn't listen to me? He says, I'm gonna grab 1,000 sandbags and make a dam to keep a house dry. So he's gonna act. He's gonna do something about the flooding. So he, in the last picture, says, oh, what you can do. So Lambieke says, oh, what you wanted to do is to show, to boost like a showman, you know, to act like a showman that is on his own, grab loads of sandbags, carrying it down the street. So here is a jealous tone that Jeromeke wants to do something about the flooding. So the only thing you want to do about the flooding is to make sandbags. And he is man of doing, not asking. So if something needs to be done, he's going to do it. So he's not going to ask, can you help? Can you help? Can you help? Can you help me? Can you help me? He's not going to ask like 10 or 20 people, can you help me? No, he's gonna do it. So, and he's gonna be jealous, like, oh, you wanna be the one to be the hero, you wanna be the one to do the heavy lifting and show your abs, your muscles, and so you can already taste the atmosphere here. So here it starts like everybody's flooded. All the houses are flooded, and she thinks, oh, maybe we can go to our uncle Lambieke. He's always nice and kind, but that's not true. He's not always nice and kind. He's always nice and kind. Maybe if we can ask him, we can go to his house and we can get out of the flood. We're gonna be saved by Lambieke. But the weird thing is, I think Lambieke lives at the end of the street, so they are also flooded. So this is what Aunt Sidonia didn't think carefully. She thought, I'm flooded, but they are not flooded. But apparently you can see the both houses are flooded. So that's the tone is already started with humor, with a thing that's actual in what's happening in the Netherlands or all over the world. Flooding is a thing that can happen any other country. So, and then you can see the dynamic between the two people that lives together, that they are, well, he's jealous of Jeromeke because he is the muscles in the family, you know, and he's the all the things you don't want to see in a man. So that's the thing. And yeah, I love this family. It's quite some time I've read Siskavisca, so I was curious about with this new illustrator, how far did he go? I think he's gone quite far, because I can see normally in the back there's a list of the issues that has been all over the years, but now apparently the issues are now in the almost the last page. So all the issues from the new illustrator, I call it new illustrator, it's not new anymore, but from the new illustrator, he started with number 300, and then he made like the issue from this one is 354, and you can see it here, it says 354. So this is the current one, the one that I'm now buying and having here in front of me. So this new illustrationist has already made like 54 issues since Willy van der Steen died. I've missed like 54 issues. I've missed 54 issues. But here they have also Suske Wiske. They call it classics. It was when Willy van der Steen was still alive. He made these issues, but they only took like 18 of the... How many did he make? I think over 400 issues. I'm not sure. I think it's over 400 issues. He made quite a lot. But they grabbed out of, let's say 400 issues, they grabbed only 28 to make it like here classics. And they are sold for €3.99. But these issues from number 300 till 354, they are still sold for like €8. So you can, or you can go to the market and buy it second hand, or go to antique store, buy it second hand. But yeah, these are only people like me that are interested in Siska Wiska. So I don't think people now, I don't think the kids nowadays love to read Siska Wiska. It's only old people like me that collected these. So I've collected some of them. I've not collected all of them. But of course I can go to Facebook and get all the people that have collected them and want to get rid of their own collection. I can buy that, of course. But I don't want to. So... Oh yeah, you know that these Son of Siska Wiska, these issues, the old ones, are worth of money? Well, not a lot. Not a lot. But do you know that there are also Siska Wiska issues that are underground? I don't know. I don't think a lot of people know. I think me and some people know. You know, I've talked in the past about my best friend. My best friend. He is... homosexual. I told about him a couple of times. I won't mention his name. He is not living here in the Netherlands. He lives in Belgium. He has his own pharmacy. So he is his own boss. when my best friend still lived here, when he was young, I could just walk out of my house here in the street and walk towards his house. Because I was only allowed to go his house by myself. And I asked them, can I play at his house? And they say, okay, you can. Sometimes not, but most of the time I was allowed. So one day, my best friend, he grabbed me by my arm and pulled a little bit. And he says, come with me. I want to show you something, a secret. I said, if it's a secret, then I don't want to know. He said, no, I want to show you something. I want to show you something. You need to see it. I said, well, it's a secret, so I don't need to know about it. You can keep it to yourself. I said, he said, no, I want to show you. Please come. So, okay, I'm going to come. So his house has two stories, like my house. My house is two stories, but my house is the first two stories of a house. His house is the stories above that. So his house, a family lives the two stories. And the two up is where he lives with his family. So his family is like his father, his mother, his big brother. And then himself is number four. And then his little sister. So he took me upstairs. That is where we called Zolder. How do you say it in English? Zolder. That's the room under the roof. It's not the basement. I don't know. I'm a bit tired now, so I'm sorry. My English is going whack. And I have not eaten, so and I'm also not hangry, but almost. But he took me upstairs, and he opened the door, and it scared the living hell of me. He opened the bathroom door. This bathroom door was as big as my living room. I said, wow. But that was not the thing, the space. The thing was, his bathroom was filled with cockroaches. Cockroaches. His bathroom was filled with cockroaches. And I'm not talking about the normal cockroaches in the house. I mean the big one, you know, I think they call it Damascus cockroaches or German cockroaches, the big ones. I don't know if you've seen it, some movies. I think it was CSI. I think it was CSI New York. CSI New York, one of his episodes was talking about a designer, a clothing designer, no, a jewelry designer. A jewelry designer that put a living cockroach on a person's lapel or above the breast, you know, the space underneath the shoulders. So next to your heart, that space where you can put an enamel pin. But this time it was a living insect, you know, to be as an enamel pin. And on the insect there were all kinds of jewelry stones, gems, glued on the crunchy outside of the insect. That big cockroach I'm talking about. I'm not talking about the cockroaches that you find in your house. Not those ordinary ones. I mean the big, big, big fat ones. That one I was talking. His bathroom was filled to the brim with cockroaches. I've never seen anything like this. You know, in my house, we never have cockroaches. But I know about cockroaches. Okay? That was something. They were so big. They were so big. He took me into the bathroom and let me stand there for a minute. I wanted to scream. I said, can we go out of here? He says, of course. He grabbed me by my arm and scooted me out of the bathroom. So, he says, that was not what I wanted to show you. That was not the thing that he wanted to show me. Okay, he was going to grab me by my arm to his big brother room. He opened the door. And it was the messiest room I've ever seen. Clothing, underwear, t-shirts everywhere. Well, it was nasty. Well, you know, boys. Sorry. So he pointed at me. Do you know this book? He pointed at Suske Wiske. I said, yes, it's my favorite cartoon book. My all-time favorite cartoon book. He says, look at it carefully. So I looked carefully at the cover. The cover, read my lips well. Listen carefully. The cover was not the same as the usual Suske Wiske cover. It was different. It was totally orange. And this little frame was like the cover. So it was all here was orange. But like something like this. This kind of space. Like this. Like the baggie. Like this. This was the space for the cover. So the cover was this. Now you can see the cover is that big. You know. It's an A4 size. But the cover was this big. I think an A6. Or an A7 size. But I'm not talking about the cover of the Suske Wiske. I'm talking about the picture on the cover. So the picture on the cover. I see a nude Suske and a nude Wiske. I see Lambiek and Jeromeke and Sidonia without clothes. I said, what is this? He says, this is a special book that my brother likes to read. These are some kind of a sexy Suske Wiske. So I think the original writer, Willy van der Steen, does not know, or he does know, that someone copied his cartoon way of the style, you know, and how the story goes inside. Someone copied him and he made it like some kind of a sex book. and it was outlawed. You can say it's outlawed. So you have to know someone to be able to buy these kind of nasty books. Not the original Willy van der Steen books. They are proper, no cursing, no violence. Even you can see they have guns, but you cannot see that someone is shooting someone. They're shooting like, you know, up in the air or above someone's head, but never in someone's bodies. So it's actually a non-violent, no cursing, neat and a family cartoon is this, Suske Wiske. But the brother, he does not have one issue of that nude Suske Wiske. He has like 5 or 7 different kinds of issues and thickness. They were somewhere like thin like this, somewhere like pocketbooks and were thick like this. And I was shocked. I didn't know that someone was desecrating. At that time, Willy van der Steen was still alive. Desecrating Willy van der Steen, his oeuvre, his work, by making such filth. He says, "You want to read it?" He said, my friend, my best friend, he opens it. He says, "Do you want to read it so you can see what's inside? All the filth, you know, sex things and such things." I said, "No, thank you." "You want to hold it?" He gives it to me like this. "You want to hold it? You want to read it? You can't take it with you home, but you can read it here." I mean, you can read it here. My brother is not home yet. But when he comes home, you have to put everything like it is, the way it is, so that he does know that no one touches his stuff, because he does know when someone touches his stuff. So he puts exactly the same way, the cartoon thing. I call it thing, it's filth. The way it was when we arrived before we went into his room. I wanted to scream. I wanted to scream about. Was it more about the cockroaches or was it more about the filthy Suske Wiske? I was so angry that someone who is so nasty, that my favorite writer, cartoon books writer, Willy van der Steen, he desecrates him, his work, even he was not dead yet. Oh, you know, you can find it. I tried to find it on Google, internet, if these books still exist. I couldn't find it anywhere. Nowhere I can find these books. I've seen them, I've touched them, because my friend pushed that book in my hands. And I said, "No, no, I don't want to touch it." And he still pushes the book inside my hands. So I had to hold it, because I don't want to drop it. And then suddenly, you know, you can nick it, and you can see something that it's damaged. I didn't want to damage his brother's books. So I did touch it. So I think there's only one way you can find those books, but I don't want to teach you. You already know how you can find those books, but oh, I am so mad. Not at my best friend, but just that the big brother of my best friend has those kind of books. It makes me so mad. And to think of, I don't know if you have heard about the story. I told like a couple of times in my videos that this big brother of my best friend abused me by touching me. Touching my boobs, touching my vajayjay, touching my butts. And I never told my best friend that he abused me. He sexually assaulted me. I never told him that. He asked me, my best friend asked me, "Did my brother touch you?" And I laughed at him. "No way. Why would your brother touch me? He knows you and I are best friends. He would never touch me." And I didn't have the heart to tell my best friend that his brother S8'd me. And it was not the first time he did that. He did it twice in his house. And then after the 2 times, he did it a couple of times more. So no, I didn't. I still have not told him. Sometimes I can see his Facebook messages You know, Facebook is very weird. I have a Facebook, my best friend has a Facebook, but I never followed my best friend. But I don't know why, somehow, my best friend is connected with my Facebook. So every time when his Facebook pops up, a message, I get the message. But I never agreed to accept him as a friend. You know what I mean? Because I feel dirty, ashamed that his big brother has ate me. So it's hard for me to talk to my best friend that he touched me. So I never told him, even when we grew up and we were adults, I never told him. When my best friend, his father died, and I went to his funeral, I went to his funeral, and never told my best friend that his big brother touched me. And when his mother died, I went also to her funeral. I never told my best friend that his big brother has ate me. Never. Because how can you tell your best friend at both funerals that his big brother touched me? You cannot do that. It's inhuman. It's not according the rules. You know, you have to grieve at someone's funeral. You cannot drop the bomb and say, hey, did you remember you asked me if your brother has touched me in an SA way? Did you remember that question you asked me 2-3 times and I denied it 2-3 times? You cannot drop the bomb. I still cannot tell him that he touched me. And the funny thing is, 2 days ago when I went home from shopping, I think doing groceries, I was wearing masks so he didn't recognize me, but I saw his big brother riding a bicycle past me. He did not recognize me. Oh my God. His black hair has turned white. He looks like, it's so funny. Do you know how he looks like now? He looks like a Kung Fu master, but without the long hair. He is so white, his hair is so white. And he looks like this chubby Kung Fu master. I say it in a funny way because he has, I think, black belt. I think he did in the past do Kung Fu. Because I saw clips of his kids when they were small. His kids are now adults now. He has 3 sons and he has a wife. I saw his kids doing on a video on Facebook. I saw it. My mom showed me. She said, look, who's on the video. His 3 kids are doing Kung Fu. They were practicing at home. And I saw one time they were having a competition. And of course they won. I know his dad. I mean, my best friend's uncle. My best friend's brother. I know his dad. He wants to do everything perfect. And everything. You know what? I'm gonna wipe you down. I'm gonna wipe you down. Okay, better. I think I fogged the lens, yes. I'm sorry. I fogged up the lens, so that's why it was out of focus. I know his father is a perfectionist, and when he does things the best. And he gives his 200% his input. So when I saw... Oh, yeah, okay. Sorry. When I saw those videos, the homemade videos, I knew that all, whatever his kids does, it needs to be done 100%. So like the Kung Fu needs to be 100%. And when they study, they have to be get A's and not F's. Always A's, not B's, A's. So I know how grueling if Chinese family can be. You know, pushing, 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 pushing. I never pushed my kids, but they still managed to do very well. I'm so proud of them. So, I'm sorry I dropped this little story. I always told the story, but I was never detailed. And this time, this is the first time I did it. I told the story in details, what he did to me. I always hid the secret. When I told the story on YouTube a couple of times, I never told it like this. So it's good to have it off my chest. It's something that I carried for a long, long time. And I don't want to carry it anymore. Even I don't want to confront my best friend's brother. Like, hey, you shithead. You did this to me. I walked this with a lot of years. And what you did to me, it damaged my whole life. I never told him that. I cannot confront him. I cannot do that. One time I told my mom, and she didn't believe me, because she was friends with his wife. My best friend's brother, his wife. My mom was very, very friends with her. I don't know, one time they argued, and now they are not friends anymore. And I don't know. I think 15 years after they stopped being friends, 15 something years, I told my mom that my best friend's brother, he SA'd me, and she didn't believe me. So I put that story to rest. I didn't want to tell it anymore. I never told my kids. My kids don't know them, don't know the family. And you know, it's good that their parents are dead, so I don't have to tell them. I don't think they would be happy if I told them what happened, that he SA'd me when I was young. So it's best to keep this secret. I know that my best friend don't watch my videos. He doesn't know that I do YouTube videos, so he doesn't know this story. He doesn't know this, my secret. So it's good that I've told it to you. Maybe you will not listen. You will skip through it. But it's okay by me if you skip through my story. But I'm happy that I've once told it. I tried to tell it in my garden. I dug a hole, a deep, deep hole. And I tried to yell at it. But it didn't help me. So I think I'm gonna end this video. I'm tired. I cannot function anymore. I'm sorry. Bye everyone.